So here's a demo on how to use the ink to build up the values really slowly and methodically. I'm just doing a very standard image, like just a drawing of a sphere with a shadow in the negative space. And I'm going to start off with the darkest values, or what I feel are going to be the darkest values. So that's going to be the shadow and probably this negative space. I'm using just a generic kind of model. I'm not actually looking at anything, but I've drawn enough spheres that I know what I'm kind of getting myself into. But from here, once I've done the darker shapes, I'm going to jump into building up the lighter shapes in a very slow and controlled way. Now, this video is 4 times the speed at like that I'm actually working. And in between, so when I put the brush down, I'm waiting like maybe 5-10 minutes for all of the ink to completely dry before I jump into the next layer. Pay attention to those cuts. Like there's one coming up here in right about now. And also pay attention to what ink I'm using. So I'm using that light ink to really build up these values very slowly. And maybe I'm jumping back and forth, but I try to stay as light as possible for as long as possible, building up those values in a very controlled way to get a nice, even transition across the surface of the sphere. Here you see I've taped down the edges of the paper to help keep it from folding or to keep it from like getting all buckled. It's fine if the paper buckles, that's totally normal when you're using a wet material on it. I don't honestly mind, but it helps to just kind of keep things flat and nice and even as you're working on it. And also when you're going to photograph it. So once you pull the tape off, if you want to tape it back down to keep it flat, that'll help kind of make it look legible. All right, enjoy.
Again,
wish I had enough, enough.
Oh, I wish I had.